talk about plasmodesmata. Okay, so we've been talking about the plant cell wall and the structure of plant cell wall. In the last video, we talked about it. If you want to know more about plant cell wall, you can watch that video first. Now, I talked about there that the plant cells behave differently compared to the animal cells. Because, you know, cell-cell interactions play very important roles in many different aspects of a cell living. For example, the aspect of signaling, right, or conveying the message to the nearby cells. For example, a cell is infected by an infective agent and the cell needs to notify all the other nearby cells that the infection is spreading. All these things, this is one example only. So for that reasons, they need to have a communication. And the cellular communication in case of animal cells is quite easy. Like, because in animal cells, we have a transport system throughout the body. And that is the blood circulation system. Blood acts as a transport mechanism through which all the materials can move from one place of the body to the other place. But in case of plants, there is no such blood transport system. So how do plant cells interact between themselves? The answer is plasmodesmata. This is a very smart way for the cells to convey messages between each other. Now, in either way, if this one cell produces a protein that needs to be spread to the nearby cell, they use this specific structure called plasmodesmata, which is nothing but a cytoplasmic linkage between two adjacent cells or nearby cells, so that they can move some proteins from one cell to the adjacent cell. Or it's say in some cases, if they need to transfer some mRNA, they can do that, right? Some other molecules, large molecules, like some food sources, glucose, for example, they can transfer that to the adjacent cells. That is the function of plasmodesmata. And if you look at the structure, it is a cytoplasmic bridge that is present between two adjacent cells. And the bridge is made by a specific structure that we want to talk about in details later. But if you see, this is the structure of plant cells and how they are organized. Because, you know, in animal cells, they are organized like stacks, like there's a basement and then the tissue. Then the cells are organized one after another and they are linked with themselves with intermediate filaments. And we call them as a tissue. Now, the tissue could contain one layer of the cell or two layers of the cell, and so many different layers are possible due to complexity. But in this case, the cells are organized like this because in plant cells, they have cell wall. Cell wall provides structural rigidity to the plant because plant requires much more structural rigidity compared to the animals, because plant needs to stay and anchored properly to the ground. For that reason, each of the cells, they have specific cellular constituents. They have their cell membrane, but they have a common wall that is known as the cell wall, which is separating two nearby cells. Now, you know, cell membranes are semi-permeable, so molecules can diffuse through the cell membrane portions. But cell walls are much more rigid and much way more solid, okay? And it is made up with carbohydrates, some filamentous carbohydrates, polysaccharides, that will make it very, very strong so that it can stand there from the outer damages, or it can resist the outer or external damage. And also it provides a specific structural shape to the plant cells as well. Now, what happens here, as they are covered with these cell walls, now if you are making a wall, it's very rigid, you cannot pass through that wall. If it's a let's say a wire like thing, you can pass it. Cell membrane is like that wire, you can pass it. But in this case, you are making the wall with bricks, so it's not very easy to pass. So in that case, if you want to pass, you need to create a passage, you need to create a door. Now, in this case, the doors are created between two nearby cells, and this door are known as a plasmodesmata. Okay, that is the idea of plasmodesmata, the link between two cells, adjacent cells. Okay, for example, one link I draw here, let's say another link you can draw someplace here. They are linked and small tunnel is present between them so that the cytosolic contents can be shared between two nearby cells. Now, how many of this plasmodesmata we can find inside the plant cells? The answer is intriguing. It's almost 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 5 plasmodesmata are present in two cells to connect them together. In one, every single plant cell, you will find 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 5 plasmodesmata or connections. So can you imagine why this thing is important? Because to spread the information, if there is something or some protein is produced by one plant cell, that should be shared by the nearby cells. If there is a lot of nutrients provided to this cell, it's not required yet, nearby cells should use it. So they will transfer that to the nearby cell. So it's a kind of continuous process to help other cells. Why? Because the cells know that they cannot stand alone. If you look at cell biology and how the cells are organized and the tissue system and then how the tissues are organized to make organs, you will understand one simple concept of your life. That is, if you stand alone, you can be crushed very easily. To survive, you need to be together. That is the idea. This cells contains everything, but still, for as one single cell, it cannot survive always, right? So for surviving, you need to connect with all the other cells together. So they are working as a unit instead of working alone. That is the idea. Now I am giving you a small example of why plasmodesmata could be necessary. Now, for example, say this cell is infected by a bacteria due to or let's say fungi, whatever it is. If it's infected by a fungi, in that case, this infection can spread from this cell to the other cells. Now, let's say somehow this cell fight against it and develops some proteins or factors that can alert the nearby cells that there's some infection. You stop or you start making some proteins which can fight against that infection. So in this case, they will involve in a pathway known as jasmonic acid pathway or J pathway. And also it is also true if an insect is biting, let's say, leaf. So the cells that are present in the leaf, they'll be alert and they'll produce some protein factors or some mediators, some hormones that will drive those insects away from the plants. So once this signal is received by one cell where it is infecting or where the insect is eating, at that location they'll make some proteins or components which will be delivered to the nearby cells. So those cells will also contain that and they can spread this idea. They can spread this idea between them. Let's say there is another link between these two cells also. So from these cells, it is also being transferred to this cell. So now all the cells will know and gather that protein and make that protein so that they can fight against the scenario. So this is a collaborative approach we can see in case of plants. So this is the approach, the functionality of plasmodesmata and why we need that. Now the second question is what is the structure of this plasmodesmata? Now the structure of plasmodesmata is also not very complicated, it's simple. It is just a cytoplasmic bridge between two adjacent cells. So let me draw the two cells. Let's say this is the cell wall that we are drawing. And let's say the cell membrane. I'm not drawing the structural details of the cell wall. This is the cell membrane in blue color. And the idea is here, it is not only interacting, it is not only present between the walls, but it's also involved within the cell membranes. And you know, outside of that, let's say, because plant cells contain most of the vacuole parts, so these are all vacuole units, vacuole. And this outer area, let me draw it with different color. Let's say this is the cytosol of the plant. On the other hand, this is the cytosol of this plant. Okay. I just draw a small part of it, only the link between. So this is it. And this red thing is a middle lamina, which is the border between two cells. So now the plasmodesmata is connecting throughout this area. So the plasmodesmata will be present between this complete area. Okay. So what it does actually, it connects the cytosolic content directly. So this bridge is connecting the cytoplasmic content between two adjacent cells. That is the idea of plasmodesmata. So if you see, if these blue molecules, whatever molecules, say proteins or RNA, whatever molecules want to pass through this, they can easily do that. The red things can easily pass through that. So once the cytosol is connected, they can interchange molecules between themselves. Now the advantage you all know, we talked about. There are also disadvantages. For example, due to some reason, if there is some toxic material buildup in one cell, that is also shared to the nearby cell, and that can spread these materials very easily, and that can be a bad effect also. But there is a way to control this movement even. Now the idea is, this is the plasmodesmata, it's a tube-like thing. Now the question is, how is it formed? Now the thing is, during cell division, we have a chromosomal segregation at the first place, the division mitosis. Chromosomes are separated, and the second part is the cytokinesis. where the cell wall will form, the septum between two adjacent cells, the newly dividing cell will form. Now, during the formation of this septum, somehow the endoplasmic reticulum of that cell, let's say there is only one cell, let me explain it here. Let's say there is only one cell and the cell is dividing, so the chromosome component, the nucleus are twice now, it's already duplicated, and the cell is start to, let me draw it. Let's say this. Something like that. And we have another layer in between. Right? So structure like that, it start to form, nucleus are separated. Now at this condition, the endoplasmic reticulum, remember the endoplasmic reticulum, somehow the endoplasmic reticulum present in the middle in this place. So now as the septum start to form, let's say the septum start to build up. So what will happen when the septum start to build up? The endoplasmic reticulum is interconnected, it is trapped inside this septum between the cells, and this septum will act as a cell wall for both the cells afterwards, right? Try to understand this. So once the septum start to form, endoplasmic reticulums will be trapped inside. So what we'll find, if you look carefully on a structure, you will also find this ER, some portion of the ER trapped there. So as the ER is trapped, there is already a link between two cells built. This is how plasmodesmata start to form. That is why inside a cell you will find so many numbers, like 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 5 number of plasmodesmata all the time. This trapment, this is a theory, and it's kind of, there are evidence to support the theory now. So they can form this plasmodesmata by the entrapment of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now as they are entrapped, so you will see three different structures now. You will see a structure called cell membrane or plasma membrane, that you know, the plasma membrane that we see between the cells, that is actually surrounding this whole structure, the plasma membrane, because you know the plasma membrane should connect that. It's nothing like plasma membranes are completely open. The idea is this plasma membrane is continuing through this area like that. Okay, so they are linked with plasma membrane also. So we have a plasma membrane, and then in the middle we have the endoplasmic reticulum trap and forming a tunnel which is known as desmotubule. Desmotubule. This structure, this specific ER structure is known as desmotubule. And we have plasma membrane, and then we have the cytosolic sleeve. These are the three structural units for plasmodesmata. One is the cell membrane unit that we know is surrounding. In the middle, the endoplasmic reticulum that is trapped is known as plasmodesmotubule, and then the cytosolic sleeve, that is the cytoplasm, you know, the cytosolic components. Let's say here this blue dots will travel through this area from that cell to the next cell. So that cytosols that are covering is known as cytosolic sleeve. So this element, let me write down the name of it, cytosolic, cytoplasmic or cytosolic sleeve. Okay, plasma membrane, cytosolic sleeve and desmotubule. These three things make the structure. Now what are their functionality? Cytosolic sleeve will contain all the materials that should be transported. And you know, through this area of desmosome, the area of plasmodesmata, I confuse with that. Desmosomes are different units. We'll also talk about that in next video. The idea is they are connected with plasmodesmata, so small molecules can easily diffuse through this area very easily. Small molecules like amino acids, small proteins and stuff. But for the large proteins, the large molecules like mRNA, those things need this desmotubule to move. Desmotubule contains a large area because you know the thinner area is only in the cytosolic sleeve. So cytoplasmic sleeve can be used only for small molecules like small amino acid segments or nutrients, glucose and carbohydrate segments to be swapped and transferred. Small molecules, small proteins can also be transferred. Short hairpin RNA, short interfering RNA, siRNA, shRNA can also move. But larger molecules like mRNA and all the components and bigger components needs this desmotubule to transfer through this. Okay, so this is the structure of Plasmodesmata, and this thing works on because you know this cytoplasm that we see in plant cell, it is always circulating like that. This is known as cytosolic streaming or cytoplasmic streaming. It's going on and on and on all the time in between the cells. And during this streaming, once they need to transfer the material to the next cell, they use this Plasmodesmata to do that. So this, in a sense, is what we know about Plasmodesmata, and I hope you understand the video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos like that. Thank you.